So for the first lending class, we first did putting the swing into our lending, making sure the swing is there. The first thing we talked about was just the grounded, our bounce, which everyone was already doing great. You can have a heavy bounce, or you can have a light bounce. And both swing, they both still convey that feeling of swing. We talked about making sure that your footwork, that you're never just doing foot, you know, you have your swing, you never just want to stop doing your swing in order to do your footwork. Now you still want to have that, the bounce usually, or if you don't have the bounce, you still want to have, so you're still, throughout your motions, you're not just going but you're still swinging, shoot, but a dot, do, but a dot, you still have that in your body. Then we took it to the way we move across the floor. So, we can, if we're swinging by our, as solo dancers, we can move consistently through our moves and they'll still have some swing to it because we're swinging ourselves. If you want to add more swing, you can do so by adding speed ups and slow downs, especially speeding up through movements and then slowing down at the end of the stretches. That's in linear motions. We can, circular motions, you can, we're using speeding up and slowing down in all those motions to keep the swing feeling going. Then we did a move that is cool in its own right, but not near as cool if you make sure to swing it. So we did 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6. This was our basic concept. And then at some point, leaders were going to go under the arm. Close up. We're going to go under the arm, and we're still holding on to this hand. And then I'm going to let go of this hand on top of my back in order to send our partner out. With the jump that goes 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6. Set, and then go on. Shoot. I got to do it a few times. Go good. 3, 4, 5, 6. Set, and then go on. Shoot. Then we switch gears, so that was the swing of our lindy, and then we switch gears and we talked a little bit about zero gravity as a rule for how we help the stretch happen. So that's the idea that if I send my partner this way with level two, my partner keeps going that way with level two, my partner's still going that way with level two, I'm still going this way with level two. That's how we maintain stretching in lindy hop, is like traveling away from each other. So then we took that basic concept and we took it to a more advanced level so that it will give us a ton of control over the dancing, where basically each connection point has its own momentum, and either the leader or the follower can increase that momentum or decrease that momentum as the connection point is forming. So I can send my partner this way with level 2, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and at this point I can start adding more momentum so that we have 5 and 6, and now we're pushing away from each other, level 5 or 6. Like, so now we've added momentum. So, we can do the same going down and up. We can go, I can send my partner out level 5. And then just relax it down to a 2, so that by the time we're in the end of the stretch, I'm only asking to move away 2, and my partner's moving away 2. If you are going to increase momentum, you want to do that earlier. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Starting with a 4, 5, and 6 is me adding that momentum. If you're going to decrease momentum, you don't need to do it that early. You can go 1, 2, 3, and 4. That was me killing it during the final triple set. So we played with that. Followers, you can add and increase momentum too, and we talked about the leader listening for that. And then finally, we use this move in order to show that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Or 1, 2 with the footwork. Shoo, boo, ba. Same thing, at the end of that move, I can step a little bit for level 2 going back. I can step a little bit more for my normal 5, or I can really step back, for level 8. Followers can also do the same thing. One more time, that's a swing out. 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Ooh, a little circle slide. Right, and then we ended class by doing some social dancing drills. The first drill, or the first challenge was break the dance, so we had a thought of break the dance, so we just tried to keep the dance successful. To show that one of the goals for followers can be taking more risks, that you're not going to break the dance for very long if you do break it. And for leaders, keeping the dance successful is part of our social dancing experience. Then the second challenge we did is the Artistic Captain Challenge, which was devised by myself and Gabby Cook, where the one person is expressing themselves, the other person is going to take the time to mechanically support them by helping keep the dance successful mechanically, to artistically and emotionally support them. So artistically, you can either go along with what they're doing or you can contrast it, but basically you're doing something purposeful in order to shine a light on that whole thing. And then emotionally support them by like either smiling or giving them verbal support, that was awesome, or by just like taking the thing and letting it live and doing something with it to show that you're that they're inspiring the dance to go further. So that's a game that both people can play, and it's a part of your social dancing experience to keep passing that ball back and forth. Yeah, so that was all the Lindy Hop stuff.
Yeah.
So now I'll do another one for the solo jazz. Solo jazz.